I heard you like butterflies. Monarch butterflies.
Now, these aren't the monarchs that you might be thinking of, such as Louis the 15th.
These are the butterfly kind. The kind that are going endangered. Endangerment is bad, and we're here to talk to you about it. Bryce Messer.
Ethan Sheehan.
Nathan Johnson.
We're the Monarch Monarchs. To understand the plight of the butterfly, you first have to understand the butterfly. Just like all insects, they go through several stages of life in which they look very drastically different. The first stage is the egg. As you can see, it looks like a tiny little white speck, kind of like a really small version of a chicken's egg. And only one egg is planted per milkweed plant, so the caterpillars don't have to compete with each other. And after the caterpillar hatches out of the egg, it'll proceed to eat 200 times its own body weight in the form of the milkweed's leaves, flowers, and stems. And after growing up to a certain critical mass, which is their max size or a size in which certain hormones are released, they form a chrysalis, which is not the same as a cocoon. The cocoon is made through the spinning of silk, while the chrysalis is not. And after a few weeks in the chrysalis metamorphizing, an adult butterfly will pop out, and you'll see them drying their wings as they get all their weird metamorphosis fluids off of them. And then they can take flight and become great pollinators and beauties for everyone to see.
Monarch butterflies can be found all across the United States. They grow anywhere where there's milkweed plants and the weather is not too cold. As soon as the weather starts getting cold, monarchs begin to migrate. On the west coast, the monarchs all migrate towards the southwest coast. Across the entire eastern United States, all the monarchs travel to one place in Mexico. That's a bit short.
Well, actually, it's probably fine because we're gonna have a...
Agriculture is destroying milkweed plants. Pesticides that are spread on fields often get run off into lakes and streams, and they'll kill milkweed plants that they don't intend to, which, Development in agriculture is destroying milkweed. Pesticides that are used on fields will often get run off into lakes and streams and kill milkweed plants, harming monarch caterpillars and destroying their habitat.
So some of you might be wondering, why should I even care about these butterflies? They're just a bunch of dumb bugs, right? Wrong! Butterflies are super important for the environment. Have any of you guys heard about pollination before? I feel like, yeah, it's been in the news quite a bit, especially with our friend the honeybee being quite a bit of trouble. So pollination is how plants reproduce. Specifically, we're talking about flowering plants, which are any of the plants that produce, you guessed it, flowers. And pollinators like the monarch butterfly are super important for that because they travel from one flower to another carrying pollen, which then is when once it goes from one flower to another, it creates the fruit of the plant, which is then contains the seed. So that is how plants have sex. So if you want your plants to reproduce and have plant babies, you need pollinators like the monarch butterfly. So if we don't have monarch butterflies, we lose lots of plants won't have as many pollinators to help them reproduce, meaning that there'll be less every generation. And the key thing is, most of the plants that we eat are flowering plants that need pollinators. So losing a few here, like the monarch butterfly, could be catastrophic for the world food supply. If you guys want to eat, you better save those monarchs.
According to the Xerxes Society for Invertebrate Conservation, from the years 2017 to 2018, the California population of monarch butterflies decreased by 86%. Now you might ask why monarchs are in danger. Monarch caterpillars only live on milkweed plants, so without milkweed, you can get no adults. That's a decent start. Now you might ask why monarch butterflies are in danger.
It's gonna be a bit hell to edit, but.
It's not only pesticides and climate change which are affecting the monarchs. The most destructive force against them right now is the complete abuse of their habitat. This is done through the cutting down of their overwintering habitats. And these areas are much harder hit because there's only a few of them. For the eastern populations, there's only one spot in a small area in central Mexico. And for the western, there are around 300 smaller sites in southwestern California. And since these sites are very small, it's very easy for logging companies and developers to come and knock out huge chunks of them or the site entirely. And when the butterflies get there for the migration, there's nothing there for them to do. There's nowhere for them to hide and be around each other and stay warm, so they freeze and die, or die from exhaustion from trying to find places to hide. As you can see in this picture, these are just some of the trees cut down in the Mexican forest where they migrate to. If this scale of deforestation continues on these forests and they're not protected, we could lose all of the monarchs in the eastern United States and Canada, since they all come back to these forests every year for their migration. If they have nowhere to come for their migration, they will not survive.
Conservation is mostly being done by the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, who are working with national parks to establish certain sanctuaries throughout the national parks, such as Yellowstone and other national parks across the nation, which they are planning. There are many ways to help conservation of monarch butterflies, from planting milkweed in your gardens at home, to writing to your local politicians about how they can re-put federal dollars into monarch butterfly conservation. Monarch butterflies not only help the conservators not only help themselves, but it also helps other pollinator species, which are much more efficient at pollinating local plants, such as bees and other flying butterflies, which are not migratory in the same sense. Now, monarch butterflies, however, are still very important, both as an icon of conservation and as a pollinating species.